in my hand Daiwa's new Matchman pellet wag rods. They're 50 quid each, so they're all the same price. There's a 12 foot, 11 foot and 10 foot versions. Now I like an 11 foot pellet waggler rod for most of my commercial stuff, but when it comes to small lakes, like the one behind me, which is a strip lake, are sometimes a little bit long because you need to be fishing quite quickly. You could be casting underarm, you could be trying to dob fish, or you might need just to go beyond the pole line, because bottom line is you can't go beyond halfway. And in this lake, it's probably about 20 meters. That's as far as you're gonna fish. And you need to be very tidy at that sort of distance. You know, you don't wanna be chucking it across the lake into somebody else's peg, because that's gonna cause you issues. So for 50 quid, well, there's been a time than I would have expected a 50 quid rod to be floppy, soppy, and probably all but useless. But these days, I'm not so sure, because every year the bar seems to raise higher and higher on budget price rods. Anyway, let's get this 10 footer set up. Let's have a look and see what 50 quid actually does buy you. So before I get started, I'll just show you my setup very quickly. I won't bang on about it because there's enough videos on how to fish a pellet waggler out there as it is without me adding to it. I am though using one of Daiwa's new carp pellet waggler floats. I have it set between two float stops. I don't bother to have two or three, I just think it adds to the confusion, and these ones fit quite nicely onto the line anyway. They're not going to move, as you can see, particularly easily. I do use though the feeder attachment rather than just a swivel. Two reasons. Firstly, it doesn't tangle because it's quite a tight fit in there for the line, and also think that because there's a little bit of body to it, when it hits, it actually softens the blow of the float hitting the water a little bit. Now you might think that the Daiwa float is just like everybody else's, but it does do something that I'm told William, Mr. Raisin, had quite a bit to do with this. When it hits the water, they actually sit very, very deep. Now, if you don't like the way they sit, because they do sit really almost flush with the surface, they do come with a screw, so you can take it out and you can remove one of the, there's actually only the one, but you can take one of the brass discs off and that will make it sit a little bit higher. My God, they're long. And that one's lost forever. And there's also an anti-splash disc on there as well. And that's just there to stop the float diving a little bit. Anyway, that's enough about the technicalities of what I'm about to do. Probably fish with 6mm pellets and feed a little and often, but we know all that. Let's see if we can actually catch something and see how the rod performs. Because ultimately, that's what I'm interested in. What you're gonna get for your 50 quid. Well, we're getting a high modulus carbon blank, so it's not graphite, it's pure carbon. We're also, and very importantly, especially if you're sort of new to fishing, you're buying into the Daiwa brand, and Daiwa recognises making some of the most sought after fishing stuff that you can get. So you are getting the Daiwa brand for 50 quid, which is, you can pay an awful lot more for any Daiwa rod. What we've got here is quite a progressive, it seems more of a parabolic than progressive action. There's some really big fish in this strip lake here at Decoy, and I think we might be attached one, but it gives you a perfect opportunity to see the fighting action of the rod, the playing action. You know, this is the bit that helps to subdue the fish and allows you to use, you know, reasonably light lines and small hooks to play them. This is obviously quite a large fish from what I can feel of it. It's at moments like this when you're thankful Daiwa have something called an arm lock on the handle, and it's this EVA strip, but it's actually flattened, and it's flattened so you can get it along your forearm so it sits, it doesn't twist. So no matter how much pressure you put on the rod, it won't twist in your arm. Other things I would look for in a cheap rod is that if the blank isn't whipped correctly with the guides, as in, you know, it needs to be in a perfect synergy, they'll rotate when it's under pressure. As you can see, there's a tiny bit of rotation to the left, but hardly anything. So that for me is, you know, is a seriously good point. The fact that there is no rotation of the blank. Guide wise, yeah, these are, I think they're pretty standard single standoffs, and they need to stand off a little way with the float rod, because I'm using a 4 pound line. You need quite a light line. So light lines in the wet, when it's raining, for instance, tend to stick to the blank. That isn't going to happen here. Nice secure lockdown DPS reel seat. Nobody understands why they're called DPS, but that's what they're called. And this is this bit here, and this is a wind down. And I mean, I just cannot get over the fact that for £50, you know, this is, you know, years ago, this rod would have probably been nearer to 350. You know, hugely impressive rod for the money. Yes, it could be a little bit crisper in the line pickup, but you know, I'm being picky. Oh, and I've managed to fail hook that, which isn't ideal, but let's pop him in the net. But it is, you know, it. Foul hooked fish are sort of part and parcel of commercials. You know, they're up, they're swirling at the pellets, so they're normally even more difficult to get out. And as you saw that, that was pretty much the fight from start to finish. The rod handled everything that fish could sort of dish out. I found it quite comfortable in the hand to fish with. You know, you've got to hold it when you're pellet waggler fishing. So I'm just struggling to default, and that is a great big lump of carp. Even though it's not fully by fair means, but we'll get this hook out. We'll put him back very quickly. I can sort of sum up for 50 quid. It's much more than I expected. And every year, the cheaper rods just seem to get better and better. For a while, we had the graphite glut, which is a mixture of carbon and glass. And as long as they were under sort of, I don't know, 10, 11 foot, they weren't a bad rod. Oh, we're just having a bit of trouble because it's seen the aerator, and so now we're going to have to give the rod a bit of teddy. Oh, just to turn him away. Oh, I'm not sure. I've tightened up a little bit on the reel. I think we've gotten away from the aerator. Yeah. So again, it's yet more proof that for £50, you know, there is a bit there. Should you need to have a bit of a tug at them, you know, and that this bit here, you know, that's where the steel comes from, and that was very impressive for a rod. I'm just blown away by the 50 quid tag. I just can't believe that the quality of the of bargain price rods, if you like, seems to get better and better. And the fact is, once you've brought a Daiwa rod, you'll probably always be a Daiwa angler. So if you're new to this sort of fishing, then it's probably a really good starting point. In fact, I'd be hard pushed to think of a better starting point. Anyway, it looks like we've got a common this time. Another huge fish. What a beauty. Now, it'd be fair to say that over the years, I've spent more money than I care to remember on fishing stuff. But I have to say that for £50, that's probably the best short float rod that I've ever seen. Anyway, I found another 50 in the wallet, so I'm going to see if there's actually the 11 foot version here.